The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall, and it's for the WWE Hardcore Championship.
Well, the challenger looks confident tonight, but I can assure you, confidence alone will not dethrone the champion.
Would you look at the look on the face of the challenger? Talk about focus.
You can feel the intensity level inside the arena rising. And I can't wait to see these two square off in one-on-one action.
We're all a part of history. Now it's time to make some miles.
Your time is up, my time is now. You can't see me, my time is now.
Introducing the challenger from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 286 pounds, he is the world heavyweight champion, Brock Lesnar. And his opponent from West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing in at 251 pounds, he is the WWE Hardcore Champion, John.
In a few seconds, the wait is over, and we will finally get this match underway.
No matter where his match is on the card, whenever John Cena's in the ring, it possesses a big fight, main event feel. It's just another reason why Cena's known as the franchise. Again, this is for the Hardcore Championship.
Oh man, let me tell you. Oh man, does he have that arm submission in tight?
King, if you had to use one word to sum up John Cena as a superstar, maybe it would be power. He is possibly the most powerful, forceful performer we've got in WWE.
Well, you can say that again, Cole. Who needs finesse when you pack the kind of wallop that John Cena does? I mean, he is all about strength, muscle, and inflicting maximum damage.
What do you think about John Cena?
Looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
Here is John Cena wreaking havoc.
Lesnar looks to be finally feeling the effects of this attack.
Avoid that.
We've been talking about John Cena's power, but we can't forget about his technique either. He is definitely a savvy performer, but I think it's the all-around power John has, power in his upper body, power in his legs, that truly puts him on a different level.
You have to wonder how much use of that arm he'll have as this match continues.
Oh, out of nowhere!
Knocked the breath out with a crushing kick to the gut.
Him to breathe for a week.
And he gets out of the way. Not today, too fast.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
Well, we're talking about John Cena's power and technique. You know, they both go snakes the cup.
One, two.
And a kick out.
And that's all that matters. This match continues. How does Cena do that? There's nobody else on this planet that can go like John Cena. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
The small, the back is absorbing a great deal of punishment here.
Oh, he missed. Oh, nobody home that time.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
And I hope we can get a doctor.
That can't be enough, can it?
I don't think so.
And the shoulder's up.
And the match continues. I love this. John Cena will never give up. I'm not sure John Cena can give up. If there's only fumes left in the tank, Cena will keep going.
You know, it's remarkable. When John Cena has his adversary incapacitated, there's always the very real possibility that he will go to the submission hold that he has developed into his trademark, the STF.
Oh, yeah.
Cena doesn't miss many chances to lock that hold in, does he?
It's the German suplex. The end is near.
Right about that.
Again, this is for the heart.
The shoulders are down.
And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. Man, did you see that, Cole? If that won't keep Cena down for the count, I don't know if anything will. Watch it. Ooh, much more of that, and he's not going to last long.
And when John Cena is able to lock in that STF, I'll be shocked if that's not it. He's setting up.
Is. It only takes a couple of those to bring his knife.
Here's the cover.
One, two.
A knockdown, drag out brawl, complete with a big stomp.
Man, these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
You're watching Raw for more than 20 years, the premier program in all of sports entertainment.
No, not again. Well, the trick sometimes when you get outside the ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary when you get near all these dangerous objects.
We're watching someone toying with their opponent. I don't know if the manhandling is going to end anytime soon, but this is almost inhumane.
You know, Michael, it seems hard to believe that John Cena has held the WWE Championship more than 10 times.
I know, unreal.
That sounds impossible. I remember.
And Brock Lesnar nails it.
Four.
We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance in there. But only one can walk out victorious. Who will it be?
Six.
He is slowly getting dissected.
One.
Oh, two. Out of nowhere.
And when John Cena is able to lock in that STF hold that we were talking about, the result is pretty predictable. Very few of his foes are able to escape it.
Right.
Cena has a lot of championship matches on his resume, and so many of them have ended on a tap out after John's applied the STF.
You know, a few of those contests come to mind, Michael. Cena used the STF to force Mark Henry to tap out at Money in the Bank in 2013. That was for the WWE Championship. And Cena finished Chris Jericho with it at Armageddon in 08 for the heavyweight title.
Yeah, remember that?
Yeah. Just goes to show you, nobody's immune to the effects of John Cena's STF. You can't say enough about the athletic skills of Brock Lesnar. Look at him go to work. Not this.
He's looking at it again. The multiple power bomb. The end is near.
And he'll never be the same after that. I have to say, when I think back on all the epic matches I've seen and been a part of in WWE, for pure entertainment value, John Cena's match against our friend.
We got a cover.
One, two.
These are great competitors. Great, tremendous gladiators here in WWE.
Some of the best superstars the WWE have to offer.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Look at this. He's in full control of this one.
The moment in WWE history that you just brought up, King,
right.
John Cena's win in the main event at Judgment Day 2005 was one of the roughest, toughest matches in the annals of wrestling.
Right.
You know, our friend John may have come out on the wrong end of it,
yeah.
But you, I am sure, take pride in just having been a part of it.
Oh, you're right, Michael. That was some match. And I know JBL likes to make excuses and still tells people he was sick that day, but you know what? I don't think that would have made one lick of difference. Nothing was going to stop John Cena that night.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve, it's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
He's simply reminding him that he's here.
Extra slow getting back to his base here. He's setting up.
Brock moves in. This could be it.
F5 connects. The F5 connects.
And momentum turns 100.
Hey, the shoulders are down.
Two.
Brock Lesnar has a
WWE champion.
Let's see what happened during that incredible matchup. One.
That'll do it. Brock Lesnar walks away with the W.
The new champion.
And it looks to me like our winner is already thinking about the next match. Always one step ahead.